For so long I carried the weight of my past, crippled by burdens like stones on my back. I thought I had fallen too far from your grace.
Welcome to Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you today.
When I was lost, so searching, you were the ground beneath my feet. When I was a blind man begging, you were the eye so I could see.
Hey, good morning. Welcome to Worldwide Recovery Radio. My name is Mike. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, wherever you are. We're live streaming this morning. We're thankful that you're here with us today on this beautiful day. Hopefully it's a beautiful evening or morning or afternoon, wherever you are. We got a great show today, so we're excited. It's all about love. So if anybody's in love, get ready to call in, because that's what our topic is all about today, love. Bill, you want to open us up in prayer?
Sure. Precious Jesus, we love you. We thank you for all that you do. Lord, we know that this show is so important to so many people. We pray that it just reaches in and touches the lives that need to hear today the topic that we're going to be talking about, the thing that drove you to come and to be born and to grow up and then die on a cross because you loved us so much. So, Lord, we want to just take a little bit of what we can share as far as that love is concerned with those that are listening today. Maybe it's between a husband and wife, or mother and daughter, mother and son. We just thank you for this opportunity to share that with those that need to hear what you have to say through us today. In Jesus' precious name, amen.
Amen. All right. Amen. I'm also here with my co-host this morning and my best friend and my partner, my wife, Polly. Good morning, Polly.
Good morning. It's great to be here.
Amen. Pat, the producer, is in the house, and Deb is live streaming, and Mr. Tom is pushing everybody's buttons, and we're thankful for him in the background.
Yes.
So
I only care about the one button.
I mean, it's a pretty important button.
It so is. If keeps us on the air.
Somebody's
going to
push
show.
It. Tom's going to do it. So yes. we're gonna thank him in advance.
Amen.
For helping us out every Saturday morning. So, you know, we're thankful for our sponsors. We're thankful for Air Team members who provide funds for this show on a monthly basis. And if you'd like to be an Air Team member, you can simply call the station and get all hooked up. There's a Share-a-thon coming up in March. And,
March 1st through the 6th.
Good stuff. So you can get plugged in. But we're thankful for our sponsors that sponsor this particular show. We're really grateful. Polly, you want to do a shout-out to who they are?
Yes, we appreciate you all. Easy Rider Motorcycle Testing, now hiring riders, located at 1080 Aviation Drive, or by the phone is 928-706-4553. Havasu Kindness, Lake Havasu Souvenirs, Christian Decor, hats, t-shirts, wooden blocks, decor, located at 2018 McCulloch Boulevard North, or by the phone 928-505-0451. Remember, kindness spreads joy. And Hilltop Community Church for Support Recovery Radio with shirts and hats, located at 3180 McCulloch Boulevard North, on the web at hilltoplhc.com. And we have a nominal sponsor. God knows who you are, and we all thank you very much.
And we have one more. Also, we have Hilltop Church that provides shirts, t-shirts, and hats for us.
I said that.
Oh, I missed it. I was paying attention to something else. So for the shirts and the hats, you can call in, and when you call in, you go into a drawing.
Yes.
Isn't that the best thing? You go into a drawing to win a shirt or a hat. Last week's winner was Karen. She got a t-shirt. So That's what happens when you call in. Our phone number, 1-800-721-9313. The local number, 928-855-9110.
Yes.
So if you call, you enter that drawing. Also for Hilltop Church, there's a golf tournament. So write this down. March 13th, and it's at the London Bridge Golf Course. And you can get all of the information and register to get on a team. You simply go to hilltoplhc.com and click on events, and that will bring you right to the tournament register.
That's 4 weeks from today,
man.
Wow. Is time flying by or what?
Wow. Yeah. We're we've got some amazing prizes. You can win a car. It's going to be really exciting. I'm excited just to play golf out there. So you know what I mean. That's what it's all about. And here's the best part. It benefits the Havasu kids, the children and the youth, to be able to go to camp this summer.
Yeah.
So what better way to invest in children and youth is have a golf tournament and raise some money and celebrate with them, because that's our future.
That's right.
Amen. Well, let me just briefly, since we just kind of yapping away a little bit, let me tell you what this program is about. It's a program about you. We've had 85 guests or so,
wow,
and many testimonies, many challenges and struggles, loss of a loved one, going through cancer, double breast cancer, codependency, love relationships, porn, alcohol, drugs, anger issues, in losing a loved one, building a business that God had given them to go help others. Other people, ride support and meeting support. That's what we're here for. There's so much information on our website, recoveryradiolhc.com. You could go there and tons of information. If you know somebody that's struggling, suicide hotline. Suicide is... It's just taken out so many people, especially through the fear and the anxiety in the past year of COVID and change of government and you know, kind of panic is setting in within people. And we have to remember, just take a step back and be calm and say a prayer, because he knows what's going on.
Yeah.
And we have to remember that. Now, don't forget, they went through... back in the days that Jesus walked 2,000 years ago, they had all kinds of turmoil, all kinds of challenges, and they dealt with the Romans who were the authority, and the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and they were people, Gentiles mixed with the Jews, and they had all kinds of challenges and traditions and different foods You could get hung on a cross like Jesus did for just speaking the word of God.
Yeah.
You could get beheaded and on. Thievery, you'd be put in jail. You could be stoned to death. There was no, there was no real court system per se protecting all of your rights that we have today. We have such a comfort zone, right?
Yeah.
You could spend 20 years... in prison with three meals and TV and on and on. And I'm not saying that that's very comfortable, but a lot more so than... And now, I was in where Jesus was captured, where he was put in prison. I was down in that dungeon, and it was nothing but stone and chains, and it was scary wicked. It was not a good place.
Probably very cold too, huh?
It sure was, yeah. And so nothing real pretty about that. So we're basically here for you, because you have lots of different kinds of challenges. We have lots of different challenges. We have struggles. We have hurts. And we're affected by it. Our families are affected by it. And so we're here for you. And so we hope that you get plugged in. Look at our website, Maybe you can be a guest. Maybe you will get a hold of our producer, Pat. We monitor all the emails. We love praise reports. We'd like to hear from you. We pray for you, the listener, all week.
Yes.
And we've heard from countries all over the world, tons of states in the United States. We're coming up in March on being 2 years old. That's amazing, yeah. Bill.
Almost the 100th show, too.
Wow. Wow. You're right, yeah. And so God has done amazing things, and it takes a whole team. I want to tell you that. It takes a whole team, at least 8 people in the week, to put this one-hour program together. And I'm so thankful for our producer who does so much work, and we're grateful. But that's what we're about. And we're going to, our topic today is going to be love. And so I hope you're excited about that.
I am.
Yeah, me too. Tell us what we're not, Polly.
We are here to support one another, not fix anyone. We don't have that kind of power, but Jesus does. He can change your life. The Bible states we are to share each other's burdens. Galatians 6:2. Come together to encourage one another, Hebrews 10:25. Build each other up, 1 Thessalonians 5:11, and lift one another in prayer. And that's what we also do. We pray for one another. We pray for all of you before, during, and even after this program is off the air. So we are praying for you. We are here for you. And I'm going to throw the number on there again, Mike. 1-800-721-9313, and our local 928-855-9110. Give us a call. We're here for you.
Yeah, you know, very important. Love the interaction. And again, on our website, I said there's tons of information. You can, if you're coming through Arizona, that's where we are, Lake Havasu City, Arizona. So if you're listening to us today, or you're watching the program, you can go to that website. And we'd love to have you for a guest if you're going to be traveling. We have a variety of ways that we can communicate. And we're thankful for you, the listener. That's for sure.
Yes,
what's our scripture today, Polly?
1 John 4:7-8. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love.
Amen. Wow. He sure is. Well, you know, tomorrow's Valentine's Day.
Really?
And I call it, I'm going to call it rookie hour, because
rookie hour.
If you're running out to get roses and a card and everything else, and that's your big moment and that's your big day, I'm going to tell you that you're missing the bus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because
if you're not doing that all year long.
You know, that's so true.
You know, I just, every once in a while, I'll just go, you know what? I think I need to get my wife some flowers.
Yes. Yes.
You know, I don't wait for February 14th.
It's got to be an occasion. No. Yeah.
Come on. I mean, really?
Yeah.
It doesn't.
No, it doesn't.
It's just
from a wife aspect.
Yeah. No.
And see, hey, wives, you can do the same thing. Give something, a love to your husband, mm-hmm, or even boyfriend. It does not have to be Valentine's Day. I mean, Mike and I show love all the time.
Yeah, it's important.
Valentine's Day is every day for us.
Yes, I agree. I didn't want to say that, but I'm glad you,
you did. Yeah.
I'm glad you said that, because, I mean, it really is. And we'll talk about, you know, challenges within love and relationships and things like that for sure. But today, tomorrow being the special day, if you're courting or dating or... I would suggest that you get a Valentine's Day card.
And maybe a balloon, some flowers, chocolate. Yeah.
Just something.
You better.
And when you get by that little tradition and you grow into a godly love, you'll realize really what we're talking about.
Yeah.
You know, Polly says a lot of times, well, I'm in the background of things. And I'm so thankful that you, first of all, you're there, but me, with God having me in the foreground, I can't see what's behind me. And all of the all of the whirlwind that goes on, she juggles behind me. And I, you know, I bring it back to when Jesus and the disciples traveled. They had an entourage.
Yes, they did.
And the women were such a valuable part of that. Yeah. To mend cloth and clothing and on to sale to trade and barter and help the mission continue. So there's nothing better than having a partner that, first of all, you can trust and you can walk with and believe in
Side by side, not one behind the other.
That's right. You know, I'm a fast walker, so I get out of.
I've learned to slow down when I'm with my wife because I'm a fast walker too. I go through the store. I mean,
yes.
You know, people are like, "Man, that guy's on a mission," you know.
Yeah.
And I'm like, "Yeah," because I want to get the stuff and get out. But when I'm with my wife, you know, for the longest time, she goes, "You know what? You just go ahead. You're going too fast for me."
Yeah.
So I would just slow down. And then a few minutes later, I'd be, you know, dragging her along, you know. And I finally got it a few years ago and realized that there is no place in that where we're at that is more important than right there.
Yeah.
Holding her hand.
Yeah. Amen.
So.
Yeah. I like that. Polly's taught me that. I get out of the car and I start walking, and I'm about three cars in front of her, and she's like, "Michael." And as soon as I hear the voice, I'm like, "Oh yeah,
yeah." And sorry, babe.
it just, you know, and then she catches up, and we hold hands, and it just changes everything.
Yeah, it does.
It brings everything to a calmness.
Yeah,
and it's so much more enjoyable
because
you know the world world's a busy place. I always say that we live in a microwave society now.
Oh, we do.
In 4 seconds, you have every bit of information you need. In 2 minutes, you have a full meal.
Yeah.
And it's go 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 and hurry, and we miss so much. I have to practice that. I'm saying that for me to hear and listen.
Yeah, because, amen. Same here.
It's real important. Well, you know, our topic today is love. Our phone number is 1-800-721-9313 and local number 928-855-9110. I'm going to talk a little bit today about myself being worldly and in the world and doing my own thing years and years ago. And I didn't know what love is. You know, I thought my worldly self and my thought process was more lust than love.
Yeah.
Right. And I followed that pattern for a long time and was very unsuccessful within relationships, because if you balance your love on lust, it fades away really quick.
Yeah, it will.
And you're left empty and searching, and lust tends to capture you with a newness, but it's temporary.
Mm-hmm.
And it took me a long time. And then finally accepting Jesus Christ. And I want to emphasize that, you know, I was more of a person that didn't really want to hear about that, that Jesus guy. And because I was busy doing my own thing. And so God and I had a parting of ways 30 years prior. And, you know, you're left, I say, you know, being a piece of Swiss cheese, trying to stuff money. And women and that cycle of lust and trying to make relationships work and going through partner after partner and finding yourself still with the holes, those voids mm-hmm. that are still there within you. And I'll tell you, for me, accepting Jesus Christ was the answer. Because then I began to receive real love, God's love. And I say, Polly, you can't give something away that you don't have.
No, I
didn't have true love. I didn't really have, I had bodily love. I had human love.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so limited. It's just, it's amazing.
Yeah.
And and you run empty many times, and therefore you have nothing to give, and it balances out to be a lust, not love. And so accepting Jesus Christ, his love began to come into me. And for 3 years, because this guy was such a wreck, I didn't even go for coffee with a woman. I didn't date at all. Didn't want to date because I needed to just keep receiving God's love and teaching me and how to be in a relationship and how to love people and how to care for him, for them. In a godly way, the way God sees people and things, not just as objects as I did.
Yeah.
And then my life began to change, and I would care for people more, and I would look at them different. I would look at them with such value, and because we really are. We're God's masterpieces.
Yes, we are.
And so many times we forget that. You know, we think we're a little bit this and a little bit that and not good enough here, not good enough there. Listen, if you just allow God's love to seep into you.
Yeah, that's the answer.
Yes. I remember our first date, Polly.
Whew, yes, very interesting.
Yeah, it was. There's a whole lot of sidebar to that, but neither of us, I did a side job in Florida for a nurse, and she had been after me for about a year, saying, I know you're not dating, but I've got this woman's number, and I never took it. And about a year later, she said the same thing. She would like to maybe get together. So I prayed for like 2 days. I never did that before. And I was like, Lord, this I'm full. You love me with everything you got. And my cup was overflowing. And I'm telling you, I never felt such peace and joy and happiness and fulfilled. And before it was, for me, that piece of Swiss cheese, I need a woman to fulfill me.
Yeah.
And that was not the case now. And I was more happy than I had ever been in my whole life. The 3 years of just walking with Christ and the men and working a recovery program.
Yep, you're a happy guy.
Yes, yeah. And then called, prayed on it, and called Polly, and we had a wonderful first date. And I actually tried to get rid of her at the end of our lunch date because it was most of the afternoon because it was Saturday, and I was a greeter at church. So I said, I got to get going because I'm going to church. I'm a greeter at the church. And out of her mouth comes, can I go?
Oh, yeah. That was big for me, too.
Yeah.
Well, it took a year for her to get the phone number from me, too.
Yes.
I was in and out of relationships, and I dated guys, there's a story behind that. But with my history of men and women, it was not my cup of tea. But because I was abused. But I was taught at an early age, okay, I'll go ahead and give you this number. And I remember I was a CNA and she was an RN. And I said, okay, I just threw the number down. I said, will that stop you from bugging me? He's not going to call me anyway. So here's my number. So I gave it to her. And that day you called was not the best day in the world.
Yes, you know, it's funny. I want you to know God does have a sense of humor.
Yes, he does.
Because when I called her and we had a quick conversation, and I asked her how her day was going, and she said, well, I burnt bread. And my first thought is, okay, well, she can't cook. And found out within our first date that she was also directionally challenged.
Yes, I was.
So
I still am.
Yes, yes. But I love you.
Yeah,
and it's so we went to church that day, and I knew this is, see, when God picks things. Both of us used that in our lines that our picker was broken. We would pick the wrong people because of some kind of attraction one way or another. But when we both stepped back and allowed God to put us together, we both say that we never would have picked each other.
No, I wouldn't pick you.
She wasn't my type, and I wasn't your type. And, you know, And it's just amazing. I say all the time, I've got our wedding picture in my office, and I say all the time that 10 and a half years in, I love her way more than our wedding.
Yeah, me too.
It's just amazing. And I, you know, you think it's just kind of sappy, but man, that's God.
Yes, it is.
Because yeah. God, again, you can't give something away that you don't have. And if you're not being filled up with God's love, pure, true love, then you're not receiving that benefit of what he has for you to give away to your partner. And even, and it flows even past that, because it goes on to receiving God's love with being filled. You're a kinder person. You're more giving. You're more comforting. You care for people more.
Yes, you do.
Just like Jesus did. Mm-hmm. I mean, he gave us the example of going right to the sick and suffering and those who were lepers and cast outs and castaways, and he went right to them. And yeah. and for the first time, Bill, I would imagine that they hadn't received any kind of even like, alone love. Nobody wanted to be around them.
No, they didn't.
I mean, so what kind of life do you think that they lived? Very sheltered, mm-hmm. Unloved. You got to stick together, and that's all you have, and it's pretty miserable.
You know, most of the miracles that Jesus performed that are recorded in the scripture had to do with him touching.
Yes.
Whether it was the woman with the issue of blood touching his garment, or him grabbing the hand of the little girl that was dead and brought her back to life. There's only one real huge miracle, and that's Lazarus, that where he just said the word, come forth. The problem with him, he would have had to go into the grave and touch Lazarus where he laid. But because of probably odor and the people that were around him, he'd called him forth. But what did they do when he came walking out, you know, unwrap him, you know, get him out of those things, you know? There was touch involved.
Yes.
There's always touch involved when it comes to God, whether he's touching your heart or he's leading you to touch somebody else's. But that physical touch that you were talking about with, like, the lepers and the castaways, the cast outs, all of those people, he touched the lepers. He touched the blind. He, you know, he did all of that. That was so unlike their culture. In fact, it was against the law.
Yes, because
he could have been stoned for that.
They were unclean.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. They're unclean. Yes. They were, I mean, and it's his law.
Yes.
In Leviticus, you know, he told Moses to write it. So for him to break that loose and just completely shatter their expectations, that was showing how much he loves us.
Yeah, amen.
Along with the cross.
You know, there's such a huge difference, and I hope you're hearing that. You know, how many times do we look for approval or our love to come from the world and so many other people? And how many times have you been disappointed or broken or hurting, and you needed that love and couldn't find it? Man is always going to let you down.
Yes.
Always.
Yeah.
But the love that comes from God is so fulfilling. It's, to be honest, it's unbelievable. It's hard to describe.
Yes, it is.
You really can't. You can see a happiness in one's marriage and how they communicate and how they talk. I think one of the best things, and you talked physical, is like there are many times that just my wife and I will be sitting on the couch and we're next to each other, but we're holding hands. And I realize that like an hour later that we're holding hands. There's something just magical about that physical touch. And that's exactly what God gives us and does for us. I don't know if you've ever experienced that. I don't know your background, but I promise you If you reach out and ask God to show His love and to come into your life, and yes. and you really want what we are talking about, a love that is far beyond anything that can even be described, you simply just ask Him to come into your life and to ask for forgiveness and ask to receive His love, and the Holy Spirit comes into you, and it's magical, and best of all, you have eternal life. And now, you know, the way love is described here on earth is just a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, because first of all, with our little tiny minds, and we think we're so brilliant and got everything figured out, but we can't handle the full amount of love that God has for us.
No, we can't.
I mean, he gave us the example of a physical love from heart to heart when he took the abuse, and when he was beaten and mocked and hung on a cross like a piece of meat. Yeah. He showed us how much he loves us.
Right.
And yes, and so that's a physical love. But to receive the love, the spiritual love that God has for us, it is absolutely amazing. It's just a wonderful experience. Now,
that love didn't stop at the cross.
No, it did not.
Mm-mm. That's our example of the sacrifice. The true love came when he rose again.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Because without that, none of it would have mattered.
No.
That's right.
No.
No, it wouldn't.
Because, you know, there was all kinds of martyrs back in those days that they put to a cross, thieves, you know, criminals, but not a single one of them have come back from the dead. Not, you know, no. Buddha, not, you know, yeah. Muhammad, not any of that. But Jesus did.
Yeah. Yes, he did.
Yeah, amen.
That's and true. You can feel his love.
Oh, yeah.
And you can't feel theirs.
No.
It's just, you know, they've got statues and they carry a statue yeah. with us. We don't have to. We carry God in our heart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and he's always with us. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, that's for sure. Hey, 1-800-721-9313, local number 928-855-9110. You know, I remember the power of knowing that you were going to be my wife. I mean, we were married 4 months after we dated.
Six.
So she says six, I say four. So, but anyway,
so it's about the same time frame as me and my wife.
You yeah. just know when you know, and that's why I want to say, if you allow God to pick your partner, mm-hmm. He knows the next 10 years of my life.
Yeah. Yeah.
He knows what he has planned for me. He knows where I'm supposed to be and what I'm supposed to do. And he's equipped me with a partner to go into that journey just like he did.
Yeah.
To be equipped. So there's such value in that, in allowing God in a godly way to pick your partner, because you can't see tomorrow.
No, we can't.
He can see forever.
Yeah.
And
which is good.
And he knows us better than we know ourselves.
Oh,
so
yeah.
let's face it. Wouldn't you want that guy to give you your partner, because yeah. it's going to accommodate everything in such a better way? Love is just it's amazing.
It is.
It's just totally amazing. We'd love to hear from you. We'd love to hear what God has done within the love aspect of your life. Maybe you want to just be prayed for. Maybe you're going through a tough time and you just want to talk a little bit about it. We're here for you. That's what this program is all about. Today's topic happens to be love, and I love the fact that I can love my wife and celebrate our love together like Christmas or Valentine's. It's an everyday occurrence, and we have to remember that there's a reason that God put us together. And it's to love one another and honor him.
Yeah.
and doing, you know, the correlation of doing something by yourself versus doing something with a partner, a friend, somebody that loves you and somebody that you love, is pure joy.
Yeah.
It's totally different.
Yeah, it is.
Right? You know, and now there's a lot of, they say that in the dating aspect, that someone can fool you for about 6 months at the most, going through love relationships and things like that. And if they haven't captured you in a way, then you really find out who that true person is, because their personality really comes out. And if you allow God to just reveal that, to show that, to trust Him in the process, you will find way more peace.
In our relationship before we got married, we basically we had one date, and that was the date that God put us together. From then on, we hung out. Yeah. We built our relationship. We went to church, and I helped out at church. I helped out at Celebrate Recovery. And when I was handing out the invitations to the wedding, people go, okay, you are renewing your vows. And I look at them, I said, how do I renew vows that we didn't even take yet? Yeah. She goes, aren't you and Mike already married? And I go, no. Why would you say that? She said, because your relationship is built so strong, we all thought you were already married.
Yeah, isn't that amazing? See, people can see, and that's another aspect. People can see the love that you have for mankind, but not only mankind, your partner. And it's a beautiful thing. And a lot of people, it's not mysterious.
No, it isn't.
And it's not unobtainable. It's only allowing and accepting Jesus Christ into your heart, and you receive that kind of love. There's no confusion with it. That's what I like about it. And you know, there many people have been married 40, 50, 60 years, long times.
Yeah.
How do they stick together? They stick together through God and the love that God has for them, so that they can give to their partners. And it's pretty beautiful to watch.
Yes, it is. And they build, because I asked a couple one time that was married. I worked in a hospital in Florida, and this lady was in the hospital bed, and I watched her, and all of a sudden a smile was on her face. And I looked at her, and I looked out the door, and I recognized the vehicle, and her husband was coming, and she goes, he's here. I said, what do you mean he's here? She goes, my husband's here. And within a few minutes, he walked through the door, and I'm going, wow, to have that relationship, to know, because I was with her, so she didn't call or anything else, but to have that relationship, to know. And I said, how long? And they were married for 60 years. 60 years. And I looked at him, I said, how? And he said, she was my best friend. Mm-hmm. We built a friendship. Mm-hmm. And then we were married in a short period of time. So that's, mm-hmm. you just build a relationship, and it'll grow. Yeah. And that's what we did, Mike.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree. How about the love, Bill, for a mom or a dad?
Yeah.
The amazing gift of a child being born.
Yeah.
And a mom and a dad just loving that gift from God and that child. That's pure love when it comes from
a mother's
from him.
Love. There's, you know, man, they always say there's nothing like it.
It's pretty amazing.
The only thing, you know, that I could compare it to is, you know, what God did for us. You know, with Jesus on the cross.
Yeah.
You know, and that is so much more than what a mom can do for, you know, the love that she has. But I would have to say that'd be the second closest thing, you know, to what God did with his son. Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm. My mom passed away when I was 12, so I didn't have a lot of experience with a mother's love until after my wife and I, my first wife and I got married, and we had our, you know, children. Then I could see it,
yeah.
You know. But so it's definitely something you just, I don't know what it is about bringing that kid into the world. You know, it's the best thing that could ever happen to you. I've had that experience 6 times, and there's just nothing like it.
Amen.
I
mean,
obviously, I wasn't the one on the you know, the bed doing all the pushing and, you know, going through all the pain, but to be there and to experience that is just, I mean, it's miraculous.
Absolutely. Hey, we got a caller on line 5, Bill, Victoria. Good morning. Welcome to Recovery Radio.
Good morning, Victoria.
Oh, good morning. Thank you for taking my call.
Yes. Yes.
First, I want to tell you guys that because the servers have been down, my pain medication didn't make it, so I'm in to my pharmacy, so I'm in real ferocious pain.
Oh,
but I wanted to call and talk about my husband that passed in 2011. He was the best thing. God chose him. The day he saw me, he knew God told him he was going to marry me.
Wow.
And the things he used to do were just phenomenal. I felt safe and secure. You guys have talked about that before, how we women really need that. I never had that with my own father.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But he used to, Valentine's Day was our anniversary.
Wow.
So
wow.
On my birthdays and on Valentine's Day, he would always, if I was working, he would deliver a dozen red roses, helium balloons, and a stuffed animal or some candy. And he used, if we didn't have the money, he had a hydraulic log splitter. He would go pawn that in for a few months just to, so he had the cash to do that for me.
Wow. Bless his heart.
And when I used to be a merchandiser at Home Depot. And when I'd be in there, they would send the guy in. And all the women would go, gosh, I wish my husband would do that.
Oh, wow.
It made me just feel even better.
Amen.
He was awesome. I mean, it was the best marriage I've ever had, best friend I've ever had.
Yeah.
We worked together 24/7, and it was fine.
Yeah.
People go, how can you stand it? And I said, we love it.
Yeah, I tend to agree. Polly and I do lots of ministry together and lots of projects together, and mm-hmm. we're really not apart that much. And I love doing everything with her. Yeah, that's your best friend, like you said. And another thing, love is sacrificing.
Yeah.
You know, for one another, and it's not about self-serving; it's about the other person. If Victoria, you obviously have had that and experienced it.
When he got ill, Motrin brought on a breathing problem, and when I worked and he stayed at home, I didn't have any trouble. I had no. It was like I was working for us, and it was fine, where I've watched a lot of relationships be very resentful, you know, because the other person wasn't paying or working or whatever, you know, but it never bothered me because I knew I was working for both of us.
Mm. Wow.
Amen.
You know, and it was just such an awesome relationship.
Now, how long were you married?
Arms, 15 years.
Oh, praise God.
And he actually came out of the VA from a homeless program they had there.
Uh-huh.
And they told him, you can't get married for at least a year. You know, and they said, it's going to fail. And every time we went to the VA, they said, you guys are still married?
Wow.
That's God.
Yeah.
Yeah. When God puts it together, it will succeed.
Yes.
In an amazing way. And what an amazing story. What an amazing story.
Well I'm glad to share it.
Well, we thank you for that. Let's pray for you, Victoria.
Father
God, we ask that you just wrap your arms around Victoria with her pain and what she's going through. And we ask that the medication get here soon. We ask that you put a hedge of protection over her. Give her that comfort. Lord, there's nothing more special and fulfilling than your love.
Yes.
Psalms 107:1 says, "Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His faithful love endures forever." So we're going to lean on that today, Victoria, with you. We'll continue to pray throughout the week for you. And God's going to give you an extra dose of peace and love today.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name, so amen.
Yes, in Jesus' name.
Yes, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Victoria. Thank you for telling us about your love story.
Bye
bye. Love you. Thank you very much.
Bye bye.
Okay. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
See, there's another great example. And it doesn't matter how old you are, how young you are, how middle aged you are, or where you are in your life. That doesn't matter.
No.
Many people are in such a worried, panic, anxiety state. And it's very challenging throughout not only the United States, but the turmoil within the world, you know, and the challenges within governments and potential wars and the COVID and on and on. And God knows everything. He knows what's going on. And we just have to trust the love that he has for us. Don't you think he's going to watch over us and get us through this or whatever takes place is by his plan. And he's got the best plan for us. And,
yes.
Yeah,
and I say this all the time, surrender to win.
Yes.
And when you do that and you ask Christ into your life, you get bonus upon bonus upon bonus upon bonus. And that's only temporary here while you're here on earth.
Yeah.
And then to be able to live forever with him in a place that we can't even imagine. And I say this all the time. I haven't seen anybody come back from heaven.
No.
And say, hey, it wasn't really all cut out that I thought it was going to be. It wasn't that great. I'd rather be down here on earth. I've never heard anybody say that. So people don't come back. It's an amazing, amazing place. Just the 10% of love that we can handle, that we get from God in abundance, is just fulfilled at 100% when we're in heaven. I can't even imagine.
Yeah. Talk about love. You know, love even grows of a, you talked about, you know, parents and, I had the most awesome mom and grandma. It's just anyone could ask for. And the love, I'm from a family of eight. There's only four of us left. But, you know, the love between brothers and sisters was, you know, I used to just torment the heck out of my brother. But what is really cool, and I'm just blessed because the love I have for my brothers and sisters and the love they have for me is just so strong. Because no matter what, you know, you torment them, but you better not torment my sister.
Yeah.
You know, I can do it because, you know, it's my blood. But you can't do it. And the love between brothers and sisters is just, I love my baby brother, Marty. He just rocks my world. He used to rock my world one time before someone dared him one time to take a rock. And I was a block away and at home, and he threw it, and it hit my head.
Knocked some sense into you.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah. No, more like into him. later.
Yeah, but I got grounded. So because evidently I tormented him to do that. But the love, no matter what, the love is there.
Mm-hmm.
Between people, and you just have to show it.
Now they're also on the flip side of this. If you think about it, there are so many people who choose not to accept God's love.
Yes,
and it's very difficult. It's difficult to watch.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. And you know, obviously, prayer for that person, family members are very challenging. And most of the world, now two-thirds of the world, I mean, they don't know the kind of love that that comes from God, because they don't have God. They don't have a relationship with
right.
him. They don't believe in him. They don't believe in Jesus.
They don't think he exists. Yeah. They think that we came from nothing. And you
yes.
know, just,
yes.
Yeah.
So they, you know, there's, I won't say millions, billions.
Yeah.
There's billions of people
yep.
with a B.
With a B.
Who don't experience or turn down or won't accept the simple love of God.
Yeah.
Now, can you imagine if the world, as one, loved God the way it's going to be in heaven?
Wow.
Can you imagine the peace and the kindness? Now, I'm a little bit older, and when I grew up, families watched out for each other. It was a different way of life.
Yes,
we had lots of freedom, and there was respect.
Yeah,
50% back in the '60s, 50% of all households believed in God, and or went to some type of church. It was a more peaceful, more kind society. We didn't have a ton of the racial divide that there is today. Hatred for authority. It's a gimme generation now, the entitlement, and there's more unkindness than there is love.
Yeah.
So we have to guard. We have to guard that and nurture it, because it's a gift from God.
Yes, it is.
And through this challenge, the pandemic is very challenging and very stressful for a lot mm-hmm. of people. But we get to love more people through this difficult time, just as in Jesus's time. Same thing.
Yeah, very much so. And you know that you were talking about we've been talking about love and God's love all through this show, but Romans 8:28 keeps coming up in my mind about you were talking about, you know, if we could see what God sees, and you know, all the pieces of the puzzle that fit together, and you know, because we don't know 1 minute from now what's going to happen, let alone you know, tomorrow or the next week or a month from now or even next year.
Mm-hmm.
But it says, and we know that all things work together for good to them that love God and to those who are called according to his purpose. So
mm-hmm.
Why not?
Yes,
that's always my question to somebody that doesn't think, you know, that he exists, and you know, or you know, I'm not good enough, or mm-hmm. you know, or whatever their excuse may be, because I've used some of those before myself. And you know, like you, Mike, I grew up in the 60s and 70s, and going to church wasn't something that we really did, but every summer I would go to like Bible camp,
mm-hmm. yeah.
you know, vacation Bible school, and learned about God's love through that. And that always stuck with me, you know, and it really shaped me and how I treated people. And I always felt guilty when I would pick on somebody, because I was a big kid. You know, I'm still kind of large, but back in, you know, middle school, football, and you know, and everything, growing up in Wisconsin, working on farms, you know, so I was, you know, kind of large, you know, muscular wise, mm-hmm. and big boned, and so when I hit a kid, they felt it, mm-hmm. and you know, I'd knock kids down all the time, and I would always feel guilty, because I knew in the back of my mind, that's mm-hmm. not how we're supposed to treat one another, you know, we're supposed to be better than that. And so it made an impact on me, even just going, you know, 1 week through the summer months to a vacation Bible school, and learning about the love of God and Jesus and you know, all of that. So,
Amen.
Yeah, I mean, what a different world we live in today.
We do.
It's sad,
do.
Too.
It's very challenging, very challenging. Hey, this has been a fast show today. It is.
No way.
It is every... Yeah,
oh,
you're
wow.
looking, see?
I just looked at my clock a minute ago, and it was like 10:30.
Yeah, well.
yeah, me too.
Well, you know.
Time flies when you're
wow.
having fun.
That's right. That's
wow.
right. So we I tell you what, I hope you've enjoyed the show. Maybe you've accepted Jesus Christ through our prayer today. We'd love to hear that. You can simply email us from recoveryradio@lhc.com. We'd love to share the victory with you.
Yeah.
We'd love to hear your story. We respond to our emails. Terry and John, who are at home doing the electronics for us, they take care of a lot of that. So we shout out to them and our team, the rest of our team. We're so grateful. Polly, we got more sponsors to thank.
Yes, we do. Just Garage Doors, now hiring, located at 2555 North Kiowa Boulevard, Suite 100. The phone is 928-855-6331. Sunshine RV, experiencing sales and service on its best with Kyle and the boys, located at 2995 Maricopa Avenue. New north side location on Highway 95 near Dillard's at the shop. On the web at sunshine.com or by the phone 928-855-6648. And Surf Pro of Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, and Kingman. Family-owned and operated residential and commercial restoration and cleaning service. They are located at 2775 Kiowa Boulevard North. By the phone is 928-855-9124 or on the web at Surf Pro Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, Kingman.com. And Ace Pest Control, serving the Lake Havasu area for over 20 years with termite, pest, and weed control. By the phone, 928-680-0988. Or they're on the web at acepestcontrol, laz.com.
LHC, I think that says.
LAZ. Yes.
So. Anyways, it is LAZ. You're right. Yeah. Okay. So, you know, we thank our sponsors so much. We're so thankful for their support. And don't forget that golf tournament, March 13th. So you can go to hilltoplhc.com and go to events. We're going to have a lot of fun. Love to see you. The Recovery Radio team will be out there. So we'd love to be able to see you.
Yep, we'll be there.
Paul, you want to close us in with a closing prayer today?
Yes. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love. It is your love that sets us free. It was love that held Jesus on the cross. It was a love that he rose again. Without love, we are nothing without you. We are nothing, Lord. We give you all the honor and glory and praise in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
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 You know, a good place to start with is just to open the Bible and read the book of John.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that is a true love story about Jesus Christ loving us. And it's an amazing book. So if you've accepted Christ, I'd suggest that you simply start there. That'd be a great place to start. Hey, great show. I want to thank my wife, Polly. Thank you so much for being on.
You're welcome.
Bill, thanks for always being there. I want to thank our producer, Deb, live streaming. Let's give it up for Deb. We really appreciate you.
Woo-hoo.
And Tom back there pushing the buttons. Hey, my name is Mike. We do a shout out to our team. Thank you so much. Love you guys. Love the listeners. And remember, keep coming back. We're better together.
Yes.
We'll see you on the radio next week. Have a blessed week.
Happy Valentine's Day, everybody.
Goodbye for now from Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you. Redeemed.